Earlier this afternoon, during a press conference which aired on Zoom, Governor Andy Beshear took some time to highlight a project that is currently underway in Pike County, which seeks to help inmates, especially those with substance abuse issues, as they rehabilitate and prepare to re-enter society. We caught up with Jailer Brian Morris of the Pike County Detention Center, as well as Tammy Riley of the Pike County Health Department, in order to get some more information on this innovative new program.
This is an ARC-funded Inspire grant. We named the project Rebuild. It stands for Re-establishing and Building Unemployed Inmates Leverage and Development. The focus of the grant is to connect substance use disorder populations with skills or support that's needed for successful entry or re-entry into the workforce. As far as I'm aware, ARC seemed to think that was a very innovative program. They highlighted it today in the ARC and the governor's press conference. And I feel that's very innovative, where we're taking incarcerated substance use disorder, you know, a demographic that's incarcerated, and we're combining that with public health services, an evidence-based curriculum like life skills, and hands-on technical vocational training with the BED program. So that's very innovative, and I think we'll be create some success here in Pike County. The program will produce 150 beds per year, and that's 75 beds per cohort, and those beds will be redistributed back into the community. I think that Brian Morse with the Pike County Detention Center, Ronnie Simmons, the director of the West Care Program, have had an emphasis for quite some time on reducing the return rate of the incarcerated, particularly those suffering from substance use disorder, and trying to provide, you know, programs. We know, and what they told me is that the Department of Corrections has shown a 41% return rate for the incarcerated in Kentucky. This was based on 2019 data. If you provide programs, you reduce that return rate to 32% approximately. So we think an innovative, really targeted program like Rebuild could even lower that, you know, more. So we're really looking forward to seeing the success that we're going to have with this program and how it's going to impact the community.
Here at Pikeville Medical Center's Heart and Vascular Institute, we have assembled a comprehensive team of cardiac specialists bringing expertise from all regions of the nation and the world. We have coupled that with cutting-edge technology, providing them the best equipment and operating rooms available. The result is comprehensive cardiac care for the people of our region that is second to none.
The Heart and Vascular Institute at Pikeville Medical Center.
Jailer Brian Morris took time during his comments to summarize the application process, as well as share what he feels could be the impact of this program on those inmates who complete it.
The inmate will go through West Care, which is a substance abuse program that's inside the Pike County Detention Center. It's a 6-month program, and upon their graduation of this SAT program, they'll be selected. I've always wanted to emphasize the reentry of the inmate. There's a lot of tools and there's a lot of classes and things that they go through while they're incarcerated. But upon their release, they're just kind of shuffled right back into the same place they came from with the same tools of success, which isn't much. You know, I've always wanted to focus on the reentry of the inmate, and I think this grant gives the three things that they need, which is life skills, education, and public health. I think them three things will absolutely give them a better success rate upon reentry. I think any time that you can help a family in need and use individuals that need to change their path of life, and you bring them two together, that's a win-win in all situations.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Joshua Sloan.